It's a pretty relaxing day. So today I'll just do a Q&A video. You know, just to be in tune with the relaxing mode. I've asked you to ask me a question on Twitter, and these are a few that I can answer right now. What time is it now? Right now it is 6:45. The sun is pretty low, as you can see. It's like right in my face. You already have a degree, so why don't you ask for a permanent job? Short answer, I already have a permanent job. This job that I have right now, being a public speaker, making videos on YouTube, and also writing books and writing for other things, this is my permanent job. Being a freelancer is a type of job. It's a job that I chose, it's a job that I love to do, and it's a job that is fulfilling for me. I like the idea of my income being proportional to the effort that I put into the job. Meaning, if I am lazy on any particular month, then I'll get less money. If I am more hardworking, then I'll get more money. Not only that, if you're working for yourself, you're self-employed, and you know, in the future maybe you'll own a business someday, then the amount of reward or paycheck or income that you will eventually get has no ceiling. The only ceiling is your imagination. There is no like a maximum income that you can get. You could go as high as you want, you know, ethically of course, or you could go as low as you want. It's really, you have more control over that, and I kind of like that. If there is a next book, what would the title of that book be? Yes, there is a new book coming up. Like I said in my previous vlog, I am in the process of writing a new book, my fourth book about parenting. Now, the title of the book is still under construction in my brain. I want a title which encapsulates the whole essence of the book perfectly. So it's gonna take some time for me to figure that out. I might ask for your opinion someday. We'll see, but it's coming, it's coming. Other than making videos, what is your job? Other than making videos, I am a public speaker, I am a book author, and I am a father. Yeah. That's a job, right? How much do you get from YouTube? YouTube does not pay me, even though I could enable ads on my videos, but I don't want to because I can't control what ads pop up in the videos. So I don't like to get money from sources that I don't know. So I disable that, so YouTube doesn't pay me at all. Nope. Do you have a child? Yes, a boy named Ryan. I'll just link to a few videos where I talk about him. But I don't show his face, and there's a reason for that. Also, there's a video explaining why. How do you adapt in Canada? I don't know, you just do. Being a human being, when you are put in any situation, you just adapt. But I think what you mean by your question is that how do you carry yourself in a foreign country? You don't want to lose your identity, you don't want to be negatively influenced by the culture, and so on and so forth. Which, by the way, is a question that is commonly asked by many students. So I think that's what you meant. The basic answer would be, if you already know the foundation of your identity, you might not figure out everything yet, but you know at the very essence who you are as a person, then wherever that you go on earth, you won't lose yourself. You'll be able to, you know what kind of friends you want to get, you know what kind of place you want to live in, you know what to do. You'll know that stuff if you know the foundation of your identity already. So that's my basic answer to you. Okay. Oh, this lighting is nice. The sun is going lower and lower. It's behind a cloud right now, so that's why you see me so fair and lovely. Yeah. My dad just caught a fish. Look, look, look. Aha! If you are a chubby man, will you do some workout or do you consume slim pills? If there's an option where I don't have to use chemicals, then I'll take that option over any other option. Although taking pills is much easier, but I don't think all easy options is a good option. So my advice would be, don't be lazy and go work out. That's my advice to myself, if I am a chubby man. What's your advice to those who are a little lost in deciding where to continue their studies when IPTA or public universities is no longer an option. When somebody says there is no other option, I am a bit skeptical and I will ask, is it true? Is it really true that there's no other option whatsoever? Because when you say there's no other option, you have already shrunk your perception of life, of your own situation. When you are in that situation where you see this shrunken perspective, then you'll be more stressed and depressed. So my first course of action would be to investigate, is it really, really true that there's no other option? Because chances are, there is another option. There are so many options around. You just have to be creative in finding them, and you just have to open your mind a little bit to the possibility of another option or options. I don't think that guy is old enough to ride a motorcycle. How should millennials prepare themselves to be a parent? Attend as many parenting courses that you can, read as many parenting books as you can, and listen to the advice of the elders. I'm not saying follow all of them, I'm just saying listen to them, because chances are they know much more than you do, than we do. It'll be a good idea to listen, and don't think that you know everything. That's my advice. What's your height and weight? Okay, I am 160 centimeters and my weight is 60 kilograms. What is your advice for those who are considering psychology for a degree? Go for it! Yeah! Psychology is awesome! What to do when we feel like a loser when we look at great people? Okay, don't compare yourself to other people. If you want to compare yourself to other people, compare yourself to your past self and see if you have improved in some way. If you want to compare yourself to other people, there is a way to do it without feeling like a loser. It's how you perceive the situation. If you see that great person as a motivation, then that's a good thing. You should do that. Why do we need Husnuzan? What's the benefit that comes from it? Great question. One of the many benefits of Husnuzan, in my opinion, is that it's good for us as the person who is making the Husnuzan. Because having bad thoughts is bad for you emotionally and psychologically, because you feel bad, your mood goes bad, and you can ruin your day just by having those type of thoughts. Why do you do that to yourself? Having bad thoughts is detrimental to you personally. So it's beneficial to have good thoughts, even though your ego doesn't want you to, but it's beneficial in the long run. You feel better, your day will be better, and you will treat people better. Is it a burden when people share their problems and put their trust on you? It's not a burden if you care. My battery is about to go out! Okay, if this vlog suddenly just ends, you know why, okay? But I'm just going to continue with...